So here I've been using just numbers as the values, but the values can actually be anything we want. They could even be other dictionaries. So if we wanted to make a more interesting version of elements, so we'll start with an empty dictionary and we can add a new element. This time we'll use the atomic symbol as the key and we'll make the value of the element a dictionary that provides some information about it. So we've added an element to our dictionary. The key is the single letter H, and it has as its value a dictionary that has three entries with the key name, number, and weight, and values associated with each of those that could be different types. Name is a string, which gives the full name of the element. We'll add another element to our dictionary. And so for helium, we have the same name, number, and weight keys. And so for helium, we have an extra entry that says it's a noble gas, and the value of noble gas is true. So now we can look up the element H. We'll see its entry. Again, note that it's a dictionary, so the order is not the same as the order that we used here. But we can do another lookup. So now we're looking up element H. That gets us the dictionary here. And then we're looking up in that dictionary the value name, and that will give us the name of the element whose symbol is H. We could change this to look up some other property. Let's look up the weight. And we can change the element to look up the value for helium instead of for hydrogen. And now we get the 4.002, which was the weight of helium. If we look up the noble gas property, we get true for helium. What's going to happen if we look it up for hydrogen? So here we get an error, and we get the same error that we got before when we tried to look lithium up in the elements that didn't include lithium as a key. We're looking for the key noble gas, but it doesn't exist.